गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक टू द चैप्टर द मुगल एम्पायर पार्ट टू। सो स्टूडेंट्स, लेट्स डिस्कस द एंसेस्ट्री ऑफ मुगल्स वंस अगेन इन दिस वीडियो। उमा शेख, अबू साद, सुल्तान मोहम्मद मिर्जा एंड मीरान शाह वर द फादर एंड फोर फादर्स ऑफ बाबर। बाबर फाउंडेड मुगल डायनेस्टी इन इंडिया। बाबर वॉज सक्सेडेड बाय हुमायूं, then came Akbar, then Jahangir, then Shahjahan, and then Aurangzeb. Although Humayun was defeated by Sher Shah Suri and he founded Sur dynasty, but after the death of Sher Shah Suri, Humayun regained the Indian empire. Now let's start with the Sur dynasty. The Sur dynasty was founded by Sher Khan. Sher Khan was known as Sher Shah Suri after his victory over Mughals. Sur was the name of Afghan tribe to which Sher Khan belonged, and that's the reason he gave the name Sur to his dynasty. He was born in Sasaram, present day Bihar. He was a courageous man with extraordinary talent. He had served as a commander in the Mughal army under Babur. He served as a governor of Bihar. Sher Shah died from a gunpowder explosion during the siege of Kalinjar Fort in 1545, fighting against the Chandel Rajput. Now have a look at the achievement of Sher Shah Suri. His reorganization of the empire laid the foundation for the rule of the Mughal emperor. He set a new trend for civic and military administration. He organized large and disciplined army. He introduces tax and collection system. He built roads, hospital, established free kitchen and organized postal services. He introduced number of military and civil reform. He minted a silver coin named Rupiah, which many of the countries are still using as their national currency. He minted gold coins called Mohar and copper coins called Dam also. He built the longest highway named Grand Trunk Road of the Indian subcontinent. He developed Humayun Dina Panna city and named it Shergarh. He gave new life to the city Patna. And some of the best known monuments built by him are Rohtas Fort, Rohtasgarh Fort in Bihar, Sher Shah Suri Masjid in Patna, Qila-e-Kunha Mosque, Sher Mandal, an octagonal building inside the Purana Qila Delhi. And these are some of the pictures of the monuments built by Sher Shah Suri. Now let's have a look at the successors of Sher Shah Suri. Jalal Khan was the first successor of Sher Shah Suri. He took the title of Islam Shah Suri, but he became unpopular because of his cruelty. He died in 1553. Then Firoz Shah Suri became the third ruler of Sur dynasty. He was the son of Islam Shah. He was murdered by his father's cousin Muhammad Mubariz Khan. And then Muhammad Mubariz Khan became the new ruler of Sur dynasty. He took the name as Muhammad Adil Shah. He was defeated by his brother-in-law Ibrahim Shah. Sikandar Shah Suri became the last ruler of Sur dynasty. He was the governor of Lahore. He declared the independence of Lahore from the Sur kingdom. But he was overthrown by Ibrahim Shah Suri. So students, now let's discuss about the most important successor of Sher Shah. Hemchandra Vikramaditya. He was a trader from Rewari, Haryana. He became the military commander and prime minister of the Sur ruler Muhammad Adil Shah. He fought a number of wars with the great success. He ascended the throne of Delhi in October 1556. He took the title Vikram Aditya. He was crowned at Purana Qila in Delhi. He won 22 battles continuously and he was defeated in the second battle of Panipat. Second battle of Panipat was fought between Hemu and forces of Akbar in the year 1556 on 5th of November. Unconscious and almost dead, Hemu was captured and subsequently beheaded by Akbar later on. The battle ended with the Mughal victory. Now let's see the Mughal Empire's second phase. But why is it called the second phase? Because after the death of Sher Shah Suri in 1555, Humayun regained the Indian Empire. That's the reason it is called Mughal Empire second phase. And what happened after that? After the death of Humayun, Akbar was crowned as the Mughal Emperor. Now let's discuss about Akbar the Great. Now Akbar was crowned as the new Mughal Emperor at the age of 14, and Bairam Khan became his regent, who was his father's close companion. Now what do you mean by the term regent? A person who rules on the behalf of a minor king is called regent, and as Akbar was minor, Bairam Khan ruled on behalf of the Akbar. Now Balram was taking care of Mughal dynasty when Akbar was minor. But what happened when Akbar grew up? Akbar took the command in his hand and sent Balram on a pilgrimage to Mecca. And cities conquered by Akbar were Gwalior, Ajmer, Jaunpur, and he conquered Malwa in 1561, Chittor in 1568, Ranthambore in 1569, and he did many military campaigns in Gujarat, East Bihar and Odisha between 1570 to 1585. And in 1585 to 1605, he conquered the areas of Northwest and the Deccan. And he conquered many other cities too. Thus, Akbar controlled almost entire India. Now, how Akbar extended his empire? Akbar extended his empire through conquest and marriage alliance. He tried to befriend Rajput by giving them high offices. And now if you remember the Jodha Akbar movie, you will be able to correlate how Akbar extended his empire by marrying an Rajput princess whose name was Jodha. Jodha was the Rajput princess of Amer, but Maharana Pratap was the only king who did not accept Akbar as his overlord, and as a result, battle of Haldighati happened. Battle of Haldighati, the shortest battle in the Indian history. The famous battle of Haldighati was fought on June 21, 1576. The battle was fought between Rana of Mewar, Maharana Pratap, and Akbar's army led by Man Singh first. This was the shortest battle in the history, lasting only for 4 hours. The war was a result of the refusal of Maharana Pratap to surrender Mewar to Akbar. Why this war happened? Why this battle happened? Because Maharana Pratap was not ready to surrender Mewar to Akbar. Mughal forces greatly outnumbered Pratap's men, and to facilitate Pratap escaped, Man Singh Jalla, his chief, donned Pratap's distincting garment and took his place in the battle. But what happened? He was soon killed, and the battle resulted in the Mughals' victory. Now let's discuss about the Akbarnama of Abu al-Fazl. Akbarnama was an historical document and was written by Abu al-Fazl. It tells us about the detail of great emperor reign and its policies. History of Akbar reign in 3 volumes. First volume, Akbar Ancestors. Second volume, Records of the Event of Akbar reign. Third volume, Treasure of Information about the different aspects of the empire, called the Aine Akbari. So let's discuss Sulhai Kul or Universal Peace. Sulhai Kul means universal peace. As we all know that Akbar was a liberal and he used to respect all the religion. And his chief Abu al-Fazl used to help Akbar in governing empire on the principles of universal peace. What they used to do for that? they started discussions with ulamas, brahmins, jesus, priests and different dharm gurus in his ibadat khanas. Ibadat khanas means prayer hall. And after knowing good feature of all the religion, what they used to do? They used to combine, they tried to combine it in a single faith, and that single faith was called Dine Ilahi or Divine Faith. So what happened because of this? It unified the people of different religion, and this policy bring the nation together with the feeling of oneness, and policy was followed by Jahangir and Shahjahan as well. Now let's discuss some of the important terms of this video. Regent. Regent means a person who rule on the behalf of the minor. Din Ilahi means combining feature of all the religion into a faith, into a single faith or divine faith. Sulaikul means universal peace. Ibadat Khana means prayer hall. Ani Akbari means information of the different aspect of the empire. And Jizya means tax levied on non-Muslim. So students, now it's time for some brainstorming exercise. So your first question is, who fought the battle of Haldighati? Who was the first successor of Sher Shah Suri? Who defeated Humayun? Who fought second battle of Panipat? And who founded the Sur dynasty? And as you know, what you have to do, you have to give the answer in the comment box below with your name, class and section. Thank you. So students, that's all for today. Rest of the chapter we will discuss in another video. Thank you.